Welcome to Mount Trusmadi, the second highest mountain in Malaysia. Our trip starts with a long drive from the capital Kota Kinabalu to the town of Tambunan. Upon arrival, we sign in and we prepare to continue on a four-wheel drive jeep that will take us to the starting point. A wonderful Atlas moth wishes us good luck for the bumpy ride ahead. The way is a bit rough, but luckily not too long. We arrived safely at the start of our trek. Compared to Mount Ambuyukon, this trek would only take 2 days, and it is definitely easier. Me and my girlfriend are guided once again by Mike Mickey and a local guide. The whole way until the base camp is on wooden platforms and stairs, and the first day of hike would only take a few hours. In this way, we can proceed calmly and enjoy the wonders of the forest. We are already at high altitude, where the trees are covered in fluffy mosses and various crawling plants. We see small carpets of sphagnum moss, and shortly after, the first Nepenthes tentaculatus appear next to the path. The forest here is lush and green, full of life and beautiful compositions of plants. We take plenty of breaks to spot small orchids, hidden flowers, and tiny insects. Nepenthes tentaculata is the main species of pitcher plants found at these altitudes, and we spot many different variations. It is early afternoon and we arrive already at the base camp, right next to a wonderful plant of Nepenthes fusca. We have plenty of time to explore our surroundings, but before we can set out, the weather decides to change for the worse. The mist raises up, followed by the first drops of rain. Unfortunately for us, the whole afternoon will be under heavy rain, and the only thing we can do is rest. Evening comes, and while the cook prepares a delicious dinner, we make friends with a little stick insect. Jackfruit soup, stir-fried chicken and vegetables, and dinner is served. We go to bed and we prepare for an early start. The next day, we wake up around 2:30. We grab a hot cup of coffee and some breakfast and we are ready to go. Having lost my action camera because of water damage, my main camera struggles to film in the dark. Luckily, I have some LED lights that can help me film some of the wonders coming ahead. Starting with the iconic Nepenthes lowii, one of the most famous Bornean pitcher plants thanks to its unmistakable toilet-shaped traps. Once thriving on Mount Kinabalu, now Mount Trusmadi is a much better place to see these beautiful plants. This species developed a mutual relationship with the mountain tree shrew, a small mammal which is using the plants as toilets after consuming the sweet nectar secreted from the plant's leaves. It is time for Nepenthes trusmadiensis, the natural hybrid between Nepenthes lowii and Nepenthes macrophylla, another giant that is growing on this mountain. A few hours or hike through the dark forest and we reach a viewpoint where we can enjoy the rising sun and the sounds of the gibbons. The towering Mount Kinabalu appears in the distance with the first light. We are only a few steps away from the summit. With a smile on our faces, we conquer the second highest mountain in the country. It is a beautiful morning and we are eager to explore the area. The terrain of the summit is extremely muddy and waterlogged, very different from the rocky mountain Buyukon. We have to walk slowly and balance on ground roots to move around. The summit is home to the gigantic Nepenthes macrophylla, a highly endangered species of pitcher plants that is endemic to this mountain. The stems of these plants are incredibly long, often tens of meters long, running across the mountain trees. Everywhere we look, the gigantic pitchers of Nepenthes macrophylla are hanging above our heads. As always, I couldn't avoid contemplating these wonderful plants up close. around is not comfortable, but the highland forests have something magical, and we quickly forget about the muddy soil to focus on the beauty around us. As we move deeper, Mike spots some of incredible specimens of the natural hybrid Nepenthes trusmadiensis.
1, 2, 3, 4.
These huge plants carry many recognizable traits of the parent plant, such as the funnel shape from lowii and the toothy peristome from macrophylla. We descend on lower elevation only to find ourselves in lowii territory. The strong green colors of their pitchers and their intense red mouths are easy to spot. Like many other highland species, these plants enjoy lots of sun exposure during the day and much cooler temperatures in the night, along with high levels of humidity at all times. We dive deeper into the bushes to fully admire these unique shapes and colorations. It is slowly time to descend and finish our wonderful trek. We enjoy our last moments in this magical place, already eager to come back for more in the future. I hope you enjoyed this small series about Nepenthes. Thank you so much for watching.